going to share something that I could go on about for hours, but I'm going to try to keep it short and sweet. Most of us are out feeding his sheep, tending his flock. But where two or more are gathered, here we are. We all know that I only tend to preach about things that are near and dear to my heart and soul, and today is no different. It's no secret that I love music and I love to sing. When I was in college, I lived and breathed music. I had a talent grant to sing. They actually paid me to sing. Jokes on them. I sang constantly, without even realizing that I was doing it. I sang in the cafeteria. I sang at my job. I sang on my way to classes. I inhaled and exhaled melodies and rhythms as I sat in class. I sang at my computer. Choir met twice a week, which was five times too few as far as I was concerned. I sang in the shower. Yes, everyone could tell when I was bathing. My roommate and I always had music playing. I sang at the top of my lungs in our dorm room, as if no one else could hear me, and sometimes people came in just to listen. I sang with my friends, I sang with my choir, I sang by myself. I sang. Then I stopped, and part of me died. When I graduated from college, I no longer had a choir. I worked in a library and couldn't very well sing at the top of my lungs all day long. My commute was too stressful to make any singing enjoyable. I wasn't going to church at that time, so I didn't have all of you to sing. My life situation at that time was not conducive to such pleasurable but necessary activities. Then, I came back to church. I joined oratorio, and I was alive again. I truly felt like I could breathe again for the first time in a decade. I was me again, and I felt whole. Music has the power to touch people in ways that mere words and actions cannot. Some Alzheimer's patients can be brought back into the now through the playing of music from their past. Babies and children are soothed by lullabies. Adults can be moved to tears by certain songs and melodies. We can be moved to joy or to tears depending on our mood in the song. Song is a part of all of our lives. We sing in our cars. We sing in the shower. I sing when I'm cleaning. I sing when I'm vacuuming. I sing when I'm folding laundry. I found that I whistle for some reason when I'm doing dishes. I sing when I'm shopping. I sing when I'm just thinking. We sing when we're happy. We sing when we're not. We sing when we're somewhere in the middle. We sing at home. Some of us sing in choirs and choruses. We sing at church. We sing when the Spirit says sing. We sing to the glory of God with each note, correct or not, joyfully to our Lord and Savior. Music and thought and song are referenced thousands of times in the Bible. I can start reciting them, but we don't have enough time in the day, much less in the service, to do so. Instead, allow me to present this. According to Merriam-Webster, a psalm is a sacred song or poem. A psalmody, which is my new word, is the singing of psalms in worship. And starting on page 735 in our hymnal is the Psalter, a collection of psalms arranged for devotional use. I personally turn to the psalms all the time. I find them to be the most accessible, understandable, relatable, comforting part of the Bible. I've personally found that no matter what is bothering me, reading the psalmist's supplications to God bring me great comfort and peace. Now, as I've admitted in the past, I want the cliff notes to the Old Testament to get me through that course in college, but that's neither here nor there. In the Psalms and throughout the Bible, we are called upon again and again to sing the praises of the Lord our God for his goodness, for his creation, for his protection, for his comfort and assurance, for his strength, for his forgiveness, for his help and security, for his guidance and wisdom, for his pardon, for his love, for his blessing and majesty, for his vindication, for his deliverance and mercy, for his glory, for his grace. Isaiah chapter 12 implores us to shout and sing joyfully our praises to God. Psalm 100 calls for all the lands to sing and praise his name and bless him. Psalm Psalm 66, verses 1 through 4 state, "Make a joyful noise to God, all the earth. Sing the glory of his name. Give to him glorious praise. Say to God, how awesome are your deeds. Because of your great power, your enemies cringe before you. All the earth worships you. They sing praises to you. Sing praises to your name." Psalm 68, verse 4. "Sing to God. Sing praises to his name. Lift up a song to him who rides upon the clouds. His name is the Lord. Be exalted before him." Psalm 92, verses 1 through 4. "It is good to give thanks to the Lord, to sing praises to your name, O Most High, to declare your steadfast love in the morning and your faithfulness by night, to the music of the lute and the harp, to the melody of the lyre. For you, O Lord, have made me glad by your work. At the works of your hands I sing for joy." And even when they don't specifically reference songs or singing or instruments, the psalms are indeed songs in and of themselves. But psalms aren't the only part of the Bible that encourages song. In 2 Chronicles chapter 29, we hear the story of the temple worship being restored by King Hezekiah. Verse 25 begins, "He stationed the Levites," if I'm saying that right, "in the house of the Lord with cymbals, harps, and lyres, according to the commandment of David and of Gad, the king's seer, and the prophet Nathan. For the commandment was from the Lord through his prophets. The Levites stood with the instruments of David, and the priests with the trumpets. And Hezekiah commanded that the burnt offering be offered at the altar. When the burnt offering began, the song to the Lord began also, and the trumpets accompanied by the instruments of King David of Israel. The whole assembly worshipped, the singers sang, and the trumpeters sounded. All of this continued until the burnt offering was finished. When the offering was finished, the king and all who were present with him bowed down and worshipped. King Hezekiah and the officials commanded the Levites to sing praises to the Lord with the words of David and of the seer Asa. They sang praises with gladness, and they bowed down and worshipped." In Ephesians chapter 5, we are taught to live our lives filled with song. Verse 15 begins, "Be careful how you live, not as unwise people, but as wise, making the most of the time because the days are evil. So do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is. Do not get drunk with wine, for that is debauchery, but be filled with the Spirit, as you sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs among yourselves, singing and making melody to the Lord in your hearts, giving thanks to God the Father at all times and for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ." And in the book of Luke, the angels sang at the birth of Jesus. Time and time again in the Bible, we see victories and celebrations played out with music and song. Messages are spread through song. Our lives today are not unlike that at all. We have team fight songs and cheers. We have commercial jingles stuck in our heads. We have national anthems and ballads. We have folk songs and work songs and love songs. We have lullabies. And happy birthday, anyone? We have holiday songs and carols. We have our hymns. Oh, do we have our hymns? We each have our favorites. Our hymns that remind us of departed loved ones. The ones we can't hear without tearing up. The hymns that we sing just a little bit louder than others. The ones we know without opening the hymnal. They're the ones that remind you of your childhood. Some you can't quite remember, but they're not in our hymnal. And you know you're not imagining them. There are some that your grandmother tells you about and hums a couple of measures, sending you on hours and hours and hours and hours of hunting on the internet for the sheet music. I've heard that could happen. Then, if you're a member of my family, there are the lyrics that you make up to the hymn's tunes, but those are for open mic night, not for now. Each psalm is a song unto itself. Each of our lives can be a song of praise to God. Sing out loud. Live out loud. Sing and live to praise our Creator. It's not hard. Music is what makes my heart beat. Hymns help my soul keep rhythm. And whether or not you can sing, you should. We're called to make a joyful noise. Not a precise noise, not an exact noise, a joyful noise. Shout and be joyful, all you lands. Joyfully sing to God the Lord. Serve him with joy and with gladness. Come ye before the Lord God with singing. Come with singing. For know ye that the Lord is our God, and he hath made us all. not we ourselves. We are his flock, in his quiet pastures grazing. Enter his gates to give him thanks, with thanksgiving, and into his presence to praise him, to praise him. Thanking him, sing and praise his name and bless him. For the Lord is gracious, his loving kindness everlasting, his truth endureth evermore. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As in the beginning, evermore shall be forevermore. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Father, we thank you for the gift of the words of the Bible. We thank you for the gift of the Psalms and of all the comfort and guidance that they can bring us. We thank you for the gift of song, for the ability to express our love and appreciation for you through our voices and our instruments, or even just clapping along or tapping our feet. Let us remember to sing your praises all the time, not just when we are in church, but all the time, joyfully.